Good day and welcome to another edition of 0-2 in Python programming. Today we'll be treating dictionary and data structuring data. So basically, we've done lists, we've touched on tuple. So basically, dictionary is more of a key value pair thing in that in list we have the indexes, in tuple we have the index to pick the object in the list or tuple, but here we are actually giving the value a key. So for example, here we said size fat, color gray, disposition loud, and that thing is we start a dictionary with a curly braces and end with a curly braces. That is, unlike list that we use a square bracket or tuple that we use a bracket, here we use curly braces to identify a dictionary, to start and end a dictionary. And that thing is, we separate the key from the value with a colon sign, this sign here. So basically, when we run this, for example, we've created cat with size fat, color gray, disposition loud, and the likes like that. So instead of we calling, for example, my cat one to pick on size now, we just call my cat size, that is size being the key, and it will give us the value, which is fat, something like that. So my cat has my cat color 4. So basically, this one will give us the color of the cat. So it will just give us my cat has gray 4. And we can use, unlike in naming variables that we use, we can use integers or float. We can actually use them here. So we can use integer as the key and whatever we like as the value. So that's what I illustrated here. So the comparison between dictionary and list here is, unlike list, item in dictionary are unordered. The first item in a list named spam would be spam 0, but there is no first item in a dictionary. While the order of item matters for determining whether two lists are the same, it does not matter in what order the key value pair are types in dictionary. So basically, what we are saying there is, there is no order in list. There is order in list. So the first one that comes up first must be equal to the first one that comes up first in the other list. Like that. Second object must be second object for the list to be the same. But that does not matter when it comes to dictionary. So if we run this and run this now, you can see we have cat here. Cat is in the third position here. Dog is in the first position here, and mouse is in the second position. So when we checked, if these two lists are actually the same, it's telling us false, meaning they are not the same. But when it gets to egg and arm, name equals Sophie, species equals cat, age equals 8. Species comes first here, age comes second, but mind you, the species is still cat, the age is still 8, and the name is still Sophie. This is what I mean, Sophie. So it's just that the order at which it's arranged is not the same. Unlike here, that it's the same. That it's not the same too. But here, when we run this, it will give us true, because order does not matter in dictionary. So because dictionary are not ordered, they cannot be sliced like list. You know, in list, we could say from 2 to 3. Okay, we are slicing that off the list. But here, they can't be sliced. That's basically that. So, for example, species name equals Zophie, age equals 7. If we ask for color here, it will give us error because we didn't give it color. We didn't define color in the dictionary. So be mindful of that. So if for example, here now what we are doing is we are using a while loop to generate names and birthdays. So, for example, here we said, birthday, Alice, April 1, Bob, December 12, Caro, March 4. So, while true, print, enter a name, blank to quit. That is, whenever you want to quit, just don't type anything, just click on enter. So, if name in birthday, print, birthday name plus is name, the birthday of name. So, basically what we are doing is, okay, print the birthday of so person is, so let's say Alice should be April 1 is the birthday of Alice. So that's on that. So else, I do not have birthday information for that name. So that's basically that. So it's checking if, for example, if I say Abbas now, it will tell me it does not have birthday information for my name. But if I check for Alice, it will tell me, oh, I said Alice. If you tell me April 1 is the birthday for Alice. So if I want to quit, I won't type anything. I will just press enter. I will just get out of that loop. So key value item methods. Okay. In dictionary, we have the key, we have the value, we have the item. So the key is what you use to name that particular variable, that particular item. So this is the item. This is the key. The two of them together now. This is the key. This is the value. So the two of them together is the item. So that on that now. So if I run this, if I want to print out the values alone, you can see it's giving me red and 42, which are the values. If I'm printing out the keys, it will give me the keys. So that's like the variable name of that particular thing in that dictionary. So if I print the items now, it will print the two of them in a tuple together like that. So spam.keys. So it gives me the keys list. So we can convert the keys in the dictionary. Remember when we're doing this the other time where we said something about you being able to assign variables to positions of each item in the list. So that's basically what we did in dictionary. So instead of we having to write them one by one like that, after creating the list, then creating the keys, you can do that in dictionary once and for all. So we can convert the keys in the dictionary into a list. You can even assign a variable name to them. So something like this. So for KV in spam item, print K value. This is more like the assignment we have for today's tutorial. So checking whether a key or value exists in the dictionary. So basically what we want to check is, does this key exist in dictionary? So we use the in operator. Remember we said something about this in operator when we're defining list the other time. So we can use in and not in dictionary to do that. That's basically what we are doing here. So we can do that to check for values. We can use that to check for keys, or we can use that to check for items. So that's basically what I did here. So get method. So basically what we use get method for in dictionary. So dictionary have a get method that takes two arguments, the key of the value to retrieve a feedback, a fallback value to return if that key does not exist. So for example, let's run this and you see what it's actually doing. See, picnic items, apple 5, cup 2. So I am bringing social number of cups, that's pick item, get item, cup, but you set a default value in case there's no cup in the dictionary. Then it will just print out what you have here. So for example, that's what I just did here. So I am bringing two cups. So if, for example, we don't have egg in this, our picnic item list. So if we run this, you say I'm bringing zero eggs. If I've replaced this with 10, you say I'm bringing 10 eggs because there's no egg in the dictionary. So that's on that. So sorry, something is wrong here. I am bringing social eggs, picnic item. Okay, this will give us an error because we are not using the get method. An egg does not exist in the dictionary. So in case you don't know if the item exists, use the get method instead of using the normal way of calling an item. For example, if I had used cups here, it wouldn't have given me any error in that cups exist in the dictionary. So that's basically that. So then another thing, you know, in get, we set a default value that is not added to our dictionary. So if we want to set a default value that will be added to our dictionary now, set default method. So for example, this is how the set default method actually works. Name equals spooker, age this and like. So if color not in spam, then spam color equals black. That's basically what the set default is doing. So whenever you print it now, you will have color. So instead of you writing this long line of code, there is a function in Python, a method in Python that does that. So set default value that will work on your dictionary, and just what you just give it is your key value pair. So you now separate them like me. You separate them with a comma like a tuple, the way we did here in the get method. The only difference between get and set default is get will show you the default while printing it out. Whereas set default will not just give you the default. It will actually add your default to the dictionary. And the default only works when there's no value for that particular key in a dictionary. So if we run this set default, it's now calling that color is black. So if we print black now, if we print spam now, color is automatically part of the dictionary. But if the value exists, color already exists in the dictionary now, you now call set default on it, it will actually print out the color in the dictionary. So it's not like it's replacing it. So that's on that. So message, it was a bright cold day in April and the clock was striking 13. So count. So here, what we want to do is basically convert the alphabet in this string, the way we did in list the other time. We want to convert them into a dictionary. But what we are doing is for character in message, count set default character is 0, then count character plus 1. So basically we are checking for each of these characters in this dictionary, then we are counting the number of time each of these characters exist, and we are saving them into a dictionary. So this is a string. So we are saving character into a dictionary. So basically what we are doing is this I now. The first time it sees I, sees as character. So character is now 0. So when it gets here, it counts this as 1. So if we check through this, whenever it sees under capital I, it will now increase this count to 2. Remember this one, this set default will not affect it because it's already 1. It's already existing in the dictionary. So same thing for T, same thing for space, same thing for W, same thing for A, same thing for S. For example, when A gets here now, it becomes 2. When it gets here, it becomes 3. Get here, it becomes 4. Remember, Python is case sensitive. So you can see, I is 1, T is 6, space is 13, so we have 13 space there. W is 2, A is 4, and if you count each of these things, it's actually true. So pretty printing. What pretty printing does is, instead of it just arranging everything haphazardly like this, it will arrange it one by one. So this one will be on line 1, while this one will be on line 2, like that. So that's what we use pretty printing for in Python programming. In Python programming for dictionaries. So it's still the same code, but instead of we printing out with the normal print, just call pprint.pprint. That's prettyprint.pprint. But this the code to use, not you writing the whole pretty print at once. So it will just print everything out like that. So you can try to attempt this assignment, which should be fun for you, because we've done basically everything you're doing here in the tutorial. It's just for you to check and make sure you write the right code for it. So let me make it more readable for you here. So don't worry, one of these days I'll find time to do a tutorial on how to use Jupyter Notebook better, so you enjoy using it the more. So till then, I remain yours faithfully, Abbas Olaiya. Thank you very much for today's class, and see you in the next tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video.